What's up, Alta Mesa Schools? Mr. Miller with your Monday morning announcements. After quite a rainy weekend, we're getting some sun now, but we are back here yet to another fantastic week of school at Alta Mesa. It is our last week before we move on to spring break, so if I don't see you now, I'm wishing you a wonderful, adventurous, hopefully a sunny spring break. But we also have our last week of Literacy Week, and let me tell you guys, this week has a lot, I mean a lot, packed into it. And you know, it was a great end of the week last week. We got some magical wands handed out for Literacy Month prize. It's gonna be another great week this week. So we got a lot to get to though. So let's get right into it. First, to start off, as we normally do, we start out with our character trait, and let's send it over to Mrs. King's class to talk about our character trait for the month. Take it away, Mrs. King's class.
Affirmations are positive statements to help in a challenge and overcome. When you're not feeling good, have never a false come appear after me. Come on, everyone. You know I'm better be for myself. Today is going to be an amazing day. My feelings matter. I get better every single day. Affirmations are fun and cool. They help us heal when they help us grow. If you love to learn and to keep feeling good, just sing some more. Follow me, yes, go.
I am responsible.
I am responsible.
I get better every single day.
I'm surrounded by love.
Every problem has an answer.
I deserve to feel good.
Anything is possible.
I believe in myself.
I control my own happiness.
Now we need some new affirmations that we could choose and learn to say. So next time you need an inspiration to help you have more of a positive day. Affirmations! Affirmations!
All right, and now let's send it over to, and let's find out what we're eating in the cafeteria this week. Let's send it over to our magnificent cafeteria manager and some special guests in the Alta Mesa Cafe to find out what we are eating this week at Alta Mesa.
Miss Claudia here, and I have my grandkids to help me, Brenna and Danny. We're gonna go over the menu for the week. Starting with Monday, we're gonna have cereal. And for lunch, we're going to have
ham and cheese
croissant for breakfast on Tuesday. But on Monday's lunch, we're gonna have a corn dog with baked beans. For lunch on Tuesday, we're gonna have mac and cheese. For Wednesday's breakfast, we're gonna have
cinnamon roll,
homemade. For lunch, we will have cheeseburger with tots. Thursday's breakfast will be
egg and cheese.
English
muffin.
And for lunch, we will have a taco bar. Friday's breakfast,
cookies.
Cook's choice.
I mean, cookies would be fine too.
Would be delicious. For lunch, we will have pizza, and our special treat will be birthday cupcakes for February and March. Have a great week.
All right, excellent job. Of course, an alumni and Brenna, she graduated last year, I think, or was it the year before last? Man, I get lost track. But alumni, Brenna alumni, and then Daniel, of course, one of our current students. Thank you so much for letting us know what we are eating in the cafeteria. Now it's that time. You guys always are waiting for our shout outs for the week. Let's hit that music.
Well.
All right, and let's get straight into shout outs for this week. First off, from Mrs. Douglas' class, we have Sky for being a kind friend, following directions, and trying her best. So great job, Sky. In Mrs. Schmidt's class, Kaya for always showing kindness and respect in the classroom. In Mrs. Isis's class, we have Aldo for being kind and showing respect to others. In Mr. Havlina's class, we have Zara for being a great person and just being all around awesome. Great job, Zara. Ms. Haig's class, we have Oliver Havlina for being just like his mother and hilarious. Oliver taking after the humorous footsteps of his mom. Way to be hilarious in class, just like Mrs. Havlina. In Ms. Brew's class, Riley Austin. Riley working hard on her biography report. Way to go, Riley. In Ms. McNeely's class, Kimberly for listening and showing respect during reading groups. In Ms. Hulman's class, Leilani for always pushing herself to be the best version she can be. In Mrs. Lindsley's class, we have Willow for being an amazing art buddy, reading buddy, and reliable reader for the littles. And in Mrs. King's class, Caden Barty for trying his very best on the iReady assessment and his reading and math groups. All right, great job, guys. Remember, come on up to the office, and there is a bag waiting for you with some goodies. All right, guys, for this week, we got a big week. First thing I'm going to start off is we are actually, and I announced this last night on the Sunday message, but we are actually doing some dress-up days this week just to make it fun for the last week of Literacy Month. So here are dress-up days as they work through the week. Monday is Sorting Hat Day, wear a funny hat. Tuesday is Knock Your Socks Off Day, wear crazy or mismatched socks. Wednesday is Doppelganger Day, find a friend and dress the same. Thursday is Magical Shirt Day, wear a bright colored shirt. And Friday is wear your Alta Mesa gear, like the sweatshirt. It might be too warm outside for a sweatshirt, but your Alta Mesa shirt. So we have dress up days this week. This Thursday, we have our family literacy night from 5:30 to 7. We got free food, we're gonna be giving away prizes, and there's gonna be some fun literacy activities. So come on down, bring the family on down to family literacy night. It's gonna be a little bit more low key, some literacy activities with your family, some food, Harry Potter theme, some Harry Potter garb, or like prizes given out. So that is Thursday evening from 5:30 to 7 in the Alta Mesa gym. This week, we are passing out our art club permission slips. Remember, art club is for kinder through third grade students. So kinder through third grade, Mrs. Walsh is doing the K-1. Ms. Duke is doing 2-3 for art club. Those permission slips are out this week. We also have our flag football tryouts this week. So tryouts for flag football are coming up. Flag football tryouts will be the 26th and the 27th from 2:30 to 3:30 out there on the field. Last week we had softball tryouts, but this week we have softball practices. So practices are, you guys have the practices, but will be Mondays from 1:30 to 2:30 and Tuesday through 30 from 2:30 to 3:30. So, and that out there on the baseball field. Or softball field. Mr. Havlina is running a third grade basketball camp for our third graders who are aspiring to make the 4-5 basketball team next year. So the third graders, this is for both boys and girls. This will be in the gym. This is usually third grade basketball camp. Permission slips are in the office now. They are due back by Friday and you will start after spring break. Art club also starts after spring break. We have Wax Museum coming up on Thursday as well. So our third graders have the Wax Museum. A lot of classes are scheduling to go through. We also have a special performance on Tuesday. So Enterprise High School, their Enterprise Starship program is doing a Harry Potter performance. Many of you got to go to the Cascade Theater and see that. But guess what, guys? I called them up and said, hey, we kind of have a literacy month that might be a little themed, a magical themed literacy month. Would you guys mind coming down and doing a performance here at Alta Mesa? And you know what? They're coming. They're coming here on Tuesday. So after lunch on Tuesday, there is an Alta Mesa specific performance of Harry Potter by Enterprise High School. So that is going to be really awesome on Tuesday. And then, of course, guys, we have the vocabulary parade that is also happening on Thursday. You guys are all getting dressed up and we're gonna do the vocabulary parade in the afternoon on Thursday. We will have judges. It's gonna be awesome. All of your themed out vocabulary parade stuff. Again, that is on Thursday afternoon. And then guys, we have our trimester 2 goal assembly. So this is an assembly for you students. We're gonna have a lot of fun with the goal assembly. And that is going to be on Friday afternoon to send us off into spring break, because guess what, guys? We are off for a week next week for spring break. And it is going to, once we come back, it is going to be, you know, that last sprint to the end of the year. So there's a lot of stuff happening, guys. Between, we're just packing it all in this week. Probably going to be exhausted by Friday afternoon after our goal assembly. So, a lot of things happening. I'm excited for this week. Is there anything that I am missing that I need to talk about? I just don't know.
I know the answer to the riddle.
Yeah, what is it?
Well, it's the 10 poles where the students line up, but we only need 7 numbers.
So the answer is 7.
No!
Oh,
we need the goblet. Goblet, appear! Okay. Perfect. Gosh. 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Easy enough.
Perfect.
Whoa!
Whoa! Come on, Alta Mesa.
Come on, guys.
Let's go.
Whoa!
The Chamber of Literacy is the library?
Oh, hey! I bet that's a chest we've been looking for.
It's odd that it's unguarded.
Yeah.
I bet it's a trap.
Don't touch anything!
What is that? What's that?
What's going on?
Oh no!
Harry, it's a basilisk! Don't look into it! Oh no! We can't do anything without Hermione!
Yes, yes, no! The hair growth spell worked. It worked. I think it worked a little too well. Roganus Magnificus is a good spell, but I need less hair now. Wait. I sense my students are in trouble. They need me now more than ever. But instead I will send the phoenix. I will send the phoenix with this. Phoenix! Away!
Look, it's the Alta Mesa Eagle.
Not to be confused with that eagle, no.
Dumbledore set us the sorting hat in our time of need.
But what good is that gonna do? Snakes don't even wear hats.
Oh my gosh, I'm so thankful that Hermione can't hear you say that.
Look, a Swiffer!
That's not gonna do any good against a snake.
But I can use it later to clean my room.
Oh, this'll work.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Oh. The answer to all of our reading problems is inside the chest. Oh, that lock looks different.
Oh, it's letters, not numbers.
To open the lock, we need to put in the right word, but it's a 5-letter word.
What about the sorting hat?
In realms where peaks reach to the sun, I'm a master of the wind, I've won. My sight pierces through the veils of air, in hunt and flight none can compare. With feathers brushed by the dawn's first light, I'm a symbol of Alta Mesa's might. What am I with regal flight unfurled? In the vast expanse, I rule the world.
Alta Mesa, this is our last challenge.
What is the 5-letter word?
All right, guys, you saw it right there. Our heroes made it into the Chamber of Literacy, which is the Alta Mesa Library, which kind of actually makes sense. Chamber of Literacy, Library. Kind of makes sense, but we didn't add that together. It was a little bit of a U-turn in the storyline that you open the door and you go in the, I don't know, but it works. It's magic. It does not all make sense. But you know what, guys? There's one more riddle for you to solve. There's another week of reading that you need to do. We also have our reading challenge. Again, I told you guys I wasn't going to say who was in first or second at a grade level, but remember, the most AR points or most pages read, those folks at each grade level will win a special prize at the end of this thing when we come back from spring break. So keep on reading. get your reading logs in on Thursday, get your AR test done, be the top reader in your grade level. We have a goal assembly on Friday, and who knows, maybe on Friday we'll get to find out what is actually in the chest that holds the answer to the spell that made people not be able to read. But you guys can read, so keep on reading, keep on turning in those reading logs, keep on taking those AR tests. Let's find out on Friday what is happening and what the answer to the spell cast over the school can be. And guys, let's make this last week before spring break the best week ever.